If you love liberty, declare your independence by signing the Shire Society Declaration at shiresociety.com.
To order, please. And today we have five bills before us. The first is House Bill 98, which is relative to Brewpub licenses. And I would like to welcome the prime sponsor, Representative Hunt.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
To join us and present the bill.
Good afternoon. It's a great pleasure and before you. For the record, I'm Representative John Hunt, and I believe I have several bills here today. So we'll start right in.
Yes, it is an alcoholic beverage day, so.
I've been wearing a warning tie, so. Okay, so which one we have first is
this is relative to Brewpub licenses.
Okay, is this the cider one?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Okay. So
he's supposed to tell you.
Sorry, I'm a little.
Have you been chipping?
I've been a little hungry. Hospice situation at home.
I'm sorry. Sorry to hear that. All right, tell us about cider.
I've really been enjoying my time off a little bit, certainly. Okay. All right. So this bill will be old news for everyone but you, because this is an issue we had last session, and we actually had resolved it in the committee of conference, but the speaker of the House. On the day of the committee conference report, decided that that it was an illegal compromise, illegal because it violated House rules, because it created a new fee that was not in either House or Senate version. And by that time, I explained to him that the fee was actually a compromise between the two positions. It was too late, and we did, on the House side, perform kind of a miracle, and that is that we were actually suspended the rules and put in a new bill, and we did everything possible to send it over to the Senate, but the Senate at that point in time was not accepting anything. So, having said that, so this bill, as you see now in front of you, was theoretically had a vote from the House. 300-something to nothing, which had overwhelmingly accepted. And what the issue is simply to allow a brew pub to also make cider, and without having to go, that prior to this legislation, they would have had to go get a full beverage license, whole separate license, combination license, and they would have had to have separate facilities. And everything bifurcated. And so what this bill does is simply say, yes, you can go ahead and do it. When it comes to making beer versus cider, they're very similar in production. And you can use the same tanks, the same dry tanks, you know, same operation. So I would venture to say that if you were walking into a cider operation, you would not know that it's cider rather than beer. It's very hard, unless you look for where the grain because the grain is the juice that you would find instead of the cider press. But other than that, the raw material, other than that, the most of the production is the same, the bottle is similar, and frankly, you know, cider is considered a beverage. Much like it. So,
all right. Thank you. Questions? No? All right. Thank you. Appreciate it. And we'll see you again, I'm sure.
Yes, I'll see you right here.
We have Darryl Murray from Liberty Lobby LLC, who supports the bill, wishing to speak.
Welcome, sir. Thank you. For the record, Darryl Perry, CEO of Liberty Lobby LLC. And I will probably be the first person to quote Meatloaf before you to say that two out of three ain't bad. I like two-thirds of this bill. To where it does extend the definition of brewpub to allow them to make cider. The portion that I don't like is this additional fee that you see lines 14 through 17, to where, and it even says, in addition to any other fees paid by the licensee, for the simple fact of they're now making and selling cider, they would have to pay an additional $240 per year. I would love to see that stricken, but I realize that it's probably a little late to do that. Don't know if it would wind up passing the full Senate or passing the House, but I do see this as something, a step in the right direction. Really, I think that a brewpub should be able to brew whatever they want to brew, and it should not be limited to, right now 2,500 barrels, and then again, beer, specialty beer, and if this passes, cider. There might be something else that could be brewed, I don't know, but I think that brew pub should just be able to brew whatever they want to brew, and it shouldn't have to come before this body every time somebody wants to expand it up. With that, I will take any questions.
Questions?
Darryl, thank you, Mr. Chair. Darryl, thanks for coming in and having your chat. Would you believe that the Senate tends to be more fee adverse than our good friends over in the House?
I've never looked to see, but I would, if that's what you're saying, then I would say that you're the expert on this, not me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Any other questions? All right, thank you, appreciate your testimony. All right, in support of the bill, not wishing to speak, is Scott Scher, New Hampshire Beer Distributors. Supporting the bill, not wishing to speak, is Craig Bulkley from the Liquor Commission. Is there anyone else who maybe didn't sign in who would like to speak to this particular bill relative to group of licenses? Couple more. Support Ian Freeman. Do you wish to speak, Mr. Freeman?
I mean, I can say something if you want. But.
It's entirely up to you.
Sure.
All right.
Ian Freeman, one of the co-chairs of the New Hampshire Liberty Party. I support the idea of expansion for people to be able to create whatever products they want, including alcohol. And I don't think anyone in the live free or die state should have to ask anyone's permission. So in my opinion, the bill doesn't go far enough. I'd like to see the Liquor Commission abolished entirely.
Okay. Any questions?
No, it's pretty clear.
Well, appreciate your testimony, sir. Supporting not wishing to speak is Mark Foster and Robert Johnson II. Has signed up, not indicating neither support nor opposition, nor desire to speak. Mr. Johnson, would you wish to speak?
Or support.
Support, okay, we'll mark that. And don't wish to speak, I trust. All right. Anyone else who would like to speak to House Bill 98? Hearing none, I'll declare the hearing closed.
We'd like to invite you to visit freekeen.com. Freekeen.com features audio, video, and blogs chronicling the transition to a voluntary society. Freekeen.com also has comments and discussion forums so you can be heard. Freekeen.com.
I should be in Keene, New Hampshire with the Free Staters.